Friday Films. That means Patrick Beatty is back on the show, and we're talking about some of his favorites, maybe hits or misses for the weekend, and we start out with Pinocchio.
Oh, yep, and if you remember, we've already talked about Pinocchio, but the Disney version, and if you recall, I did not like that movie, but Guillermo del Toro is here to save the day and maybe brought the best animated film of the year. Let's take a look.
Over there! What is that?
Just a puppet!
No, I'm not! I'm a real boy!
So this film took 1,000 days to shoot. Not just to complete or do pre or post-production, to shoot the film.
Really?
Stop motion animation is the hardest form of art that you can possibly do in animation. And in this, you feel the hands of each animator as they're doing each part. And it took 5 years to make. This is an incredible feat. It's fantastic animation, a story that's so heartfelt and just pure. Pinocchio is pure, and the story is about obedience, disobedience, about fathers and sons, and I get choked up just thinking. I've watched it 3 times so far.
Was it emotional?
So emotional.
Really?
Incredibly.
Because you knew the story. You knew what you were getting, and they told it in a different way?
This story has been told so many times, and each time with a different twist, and they were able to do so much with this. Guillermo del Toro was such a visionary with what he was able to do. And we actually have footage of, I was at New York, this is why I've got the shirt, at the Museum of Modern Art, at the Guillermo del Toro Pinocchio exhibit. We were the first to be at this exhibit with the director.
Wait,
and
with the director? You were
yes.
able to go in?
So this is the
what
director.
What was that like?
And it was incredible. You get to see him work the puppets, like, in front of your face. And this right here, seeing the work that it takes to make stop motion.
So when you say stop motion, is this a new technique? I mean, is this a new way of doing things?
Very old. It's one of the most original forms of animation, but it's not done so much because it's just so hard to do.
Time consuming.
And we have so many digital things now. It's easier to not do it, but the attention and the time they took.
I
love see the lighting. Oh, it's so
to
good.
See you choked up. It makes me really excited to watch it. To know it's heartfelt.
Yes, and it's out on Netflix right now. I gave it, I stopped doing ratings a little bit, but 10 out of 10.
Wow.
It's the best animated film of the year, and I had a blast. It was so much fun.
I love that you got to go to New York.
It was amazing.
Okay, let's talk about the next one, everybody. It's called Empire of Light. Take a look at this.
Look around you. This whole place is for people who want to escape. People who don't belong anywhere else.
How do you feel?
I do feel a bit numb, I suppose.
This is about a town on the seaside that has a theater that this group of kind of misfits all work in. Olivia Colman is returning from something that we don't really know about. She's been working with a therapist, and it seems like she's growing mentally. But she falls in love, and they have a romance story with one of the new people at the theater. It's a story about love. It's a story that kind of trends into different areas to the point where some of the B stories tend to overlap and be a little bit more convoluted. So the end part, not really the strongest, but the performances are so, so well done. And Olivia Colman, she can't do
any
wrong for me.
She's an incredible actress.
Right. So I would say see it, but know that it might drift a little bit towards the end.
What or where do you see this? I feel like I never know.
This one is in theaters, actually. The next two will be in theaters.
Should you see it in the theaters? Does it need that?
I think when it comes to Sam Mendes and the scale that he does, this is a smaller story, but the scale is still grand. So a theatrical experience is always great.
Okay,
should we talk Emancipation?
Yes, so this won't be in this is actually in theaters and Apple TV Plus. This is Will Smith's new film and coming back from last year. Let's take a look.
Slaves are free. We must get to Baton Rouge, through this swamp. Lincoln's army is there. There are many ways to die in a swamp.
Directed by Antoine Fuqua, and he is a director that has a very specific style. He loves action films, and this very much steers more towards an action-oriented film. However, the way that they kind of show this story, this is about Peter. If you've seen this, it's an iconic photo back in Civil War times of a black slave with whips all over his back. And it's just one shot. It was one of the big parts that made the Southern states decide they need to stop and like free slaves. A lot of these slaves that were in southern states weren't even told until far later down the road that they were even free. So this story is about that. They tend to use that as a gimmick, though, in some cases, because they want to rely more on an action film. I don't know how that works as far as tone goes, but still an interesting watch. Will Smith is still good.
Tell me about that for a second, because a lot of people not happy with him at the Oscars last year. So will they go see him in a film?
Well, that's the thing. At the end of the day, I've always had the mindset of there's so many other horrible instances of cast directors, producers doing horrible things in Hollywood that are still working, still doing the same stuff that they're doing. With Will Smith's case, I feel like we've seen a year of hopefully progress. He's not invited back to the Oscars still, so that's something that he still has to
bear,
right? Yeah. But the man's got to have a career. The man's got to do the things that he loves. And
did you love this Will Smith in this character?
I loved Will Smith, didn't love the movie. So it's interesting.
That one also in theaters. PatrickBeattyReviews.com, everybody. He's on social media and a link on our website. Check out his reviews before you go check out any of those movies this week. ABC4.com/GTU.
Thank you, Patrick.
Up next, what you need to know headed into cold and flu season.
That's right. And also coming up on GTU, what are some of the most searched topics of the year? We're talking about what our collective search history says about us in 2022.